Fibronectin is an ancient protein in evolution. Since it was first identified in the late 1940s, fibronectin has been very well recognized as a major extramatrix protein. In blood, it's abundant with a concentration that varies from 230 to 650 microgram per milliliter. Plasma fibronectin has long been suspected to play a role in hemostasis, but direct evidence for this has been lacking. In this study, we have established several strains of gene-deficient mice with help from Dr. Fessler, Dr. Deegan, Dr. Wagner. We demonstrated for the first time that plasma fibronectin is vital to control bleeding in fibrinogen-deficient mice and in wild-type mice given anticoagulants. The anticoagulant-treated healthy animals may mimic the situation in human patients who receive anticoagulants during surgery. How can plasma fibronectin control the bleeding? My PhD student Yiming Wang and my research fellow Adley Rahman, both having received their MDs from China, have worked on this project for many years. They found plasma fibronectin can rapidly deposit at the site of vessel injury and initiate hemostasis, and even before platelet accumulation. Platelet accumulation has been widely considered as the first wave of hemostasis, but we have found plasma fibronectin deposition, or what we call protein wave hemostasis, may occur even earlier than the classical first wave of hemostasis. We found this plasma fibronectin deposition is independent of fibrinogen, von Willebrand factor, beta-3 integrin, and platelet. Using confocal and scanning electron microscopy, we further found that plasma fibronectin can integrate it into fibrin and increase fibrin-fibril diameter, enhancing the mechanical strength of clots. Very interestingly, plasma fibronectin promotes platelet aggregation when it's linked with fibrin, but inhibits platelet aggregation when fibrin is absent. Therefore, at the site of vascular injury, plasma fibronectin may quickly deposit to the injured vessel wall, then interact with the fibrin to stop bleeding. Afterwards, it gradually switches from supporting hemostasis to inhibiting thrombosis and preventing vessel occlusion, following the fibrin gradient that decreases farther from the injured endothelium. Our data established that plasma fibronectin is a supportive factor in hemostasis, which is vital and coagulation deficient, both genetic and therapeutic conditions. By interacting with the fibrin and the platelet beta-3 integrin, plasma fibronectin plays a unique self-limiting regulatory role in thrombosis. To the best of our knowledge, this is the first plasma protein that supports hemostasis but inhibits thrombosis. Our study suggests that plasma fibronectin transfusion may be a potential therapy in controlling bleeding disorders, particularly in association with anticoagulant therapy.